I was a little intimidated. I'm really a huge fan of him. And James Taylor was, I grew up listening to him and trying to figure out his songs on guitar and going to all his concerts. So great. I gave him an opportunity to meet a lot of his idols I had growing up. And he was one of them. And when he came on the show, he was Steve Martin. He was dancing with Steve Martin. He was my two favorites.
What are you doing, stupid?
I love Steve Martin, yeah. You don't like his banjo player.
You're a banjo player, aren't you?
Are you a banjo
player?
I'm a closet banjo.
Want to drive him around the way?
It's not that I don't like his banjo. In other words, when he goes on a show, no one wants to really. Let's be honest. No one wants to see Steve Martin playing the banjo. He's a brilliant comic and writer.
Thank you.
Movie star and everything you could think of.
Yeah.
At least somebody was polite, even if it was a Mercedes driver.
I watch Steve, then he comes on with the banjo, and I turn the light.
I was having problems with the damn Hummer wouldn't move, even though he had plenty of space. I don't know what the hell he was waiting for.
I think he's slowly edging back into doing stand-up comedy. And he's using the banjo as kind of like a buffer.
Well, that was always his safety net, that banjo.
What color would you like me to paint it? If green isn't appropriate for you. You know, you could have made that light if you weren't so slow on the go. I guess I'd rather run a red light. Sit there in the green and run a red one.
You haven't even done a thing yet. You've already beaten two of the guys. You only have to get past Elephant Boy. You won't even have to go if Elephant Boy doesn't steal from you. All right, JD, Judge JD, can you see Elephant Boy at the birthday show?
Well, it's a good thing nobody was next to you, lady. Otherwise, you would have.
On this show. I think Bobo would even agree with that.
Yes.
Hey, JD.
Well, I know. I told her that. I said, you know, it's just cut right in front like an idiot. Story four, you know. That is one blue truck. Kind of annoying. I love blue, but that's kind of annoying.
Because I'll be fine during the show.
I know, you're so fucking lucky. My timing blows. Hey, anyway, I want to get to this JD date, so why don't we take a break and then we'll come back and we'll get the whole JD thing going. I want to see the beauties that are coming in here. I hear they're beautiful women.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely.
What?
Love the Howard Stern Show, but I can't have you on, brother. Can't believe you called me on my very first day doing mornings. All right? Have a good
day. My grandfather, the big
man. I gotta go, Richie. Good boy. See, if they start talking, then
it's a good thing I moved.
I may have to go to commercial break and stuff, but Richard and Sal from Howard Stern Show like to call the radio stations all over the country when they're doing their features and call in, so they may block all the lines. I may have to deal with that today. Richard Christie calling me. Beautiful. It's all right.
Freaking
Lakers, no nothing. Here. Training's gonna continue with more coming up. Yeah. Wins, aren't we?
Gotta be a moron today. Now he turns on his blinker. What an idiot. look, here's that new CHP SUV. There's a CHP out here, it's a brand new SUV. He was tailing me the other day, making sure I wasn't speeding. Yeah. And here's this guy who's coming out an in only. These people are. Motorcycles going way too fast for as slow as traffic's going. What the hell is this? A freaking blinker. These two are blocked up in here that nobody can get out of this driveway. This guy's going on the wrong side of the driveway if he can squeeze out because that pickup truck up there is blocking the driveway. An SUV actually.
Pack myself up.
go live out there as a homeless person with no job, no nothing, just live off the fat of the land. Sitting on the other side in the dark without his lights on.
Thank you.